Hi, and welcome to another episode of Data Exposed. I'm Jeroen, and in this short video, I'll explain to you how you can import a database from a backpack file. So, importing a database, right? So how do we do that? Well, the first thing you need is a backpack file. So you need to create a backpack file from any database you already have, like a SQL database somewhere, right? Then we'll make sure to upload the database into Azure. I'll show you where you need to upload it. And then I'll also show you how to import it. And then at the end of this video, you'll have your database restored or imported into Azure on SQL database. Okay, so let's just get started. So first off, I assume you created the backpack file. Okay, so you have it. And then what you need to do is you create a storage account if you don't already have one in Azure, just a regular storage account. And then you upload that backpack file in your storage account. It doesn't really matter which tool you choose. You could use Azure Data Storage Explorer, AZ Copy, anything. You could even go into the portal and just click upload here. As you can see on my screen, you could do that. It doesn't matter which one you pick. Make sure to upload it as a block blob though. As you can see here, the blob type needs to be that. Otherwise, you might run into trouble later. So now you should have your backpack file uploaded to a storage account you have access to, okay? Next up, you need to create a SQL server. We call it a logical server. It's a logical grouping for databases in Azure. If you already have a SQL database in Azure, you already have one of these. If not, just create an empty one. You'll need it. You'll need it to go into this logical server, this logical grouping, and then click import here to do the database import. Okay, so that should be there. So once you have it, you go into the management pane for this. You don't click new database. Remember, we're trying to restore or import the database from a backpack file that we created. So we're not clicking new here. That would basically give you a new database or one from a sample. We're not doing new pool, new data warehouse. The one we're looking for is import database. Okay, so we're gonna go here. Then I can switch subscriptions if I have my storage account in a different subscription than the database server that I'm restoring to. And then I need to provide the storage account details. So I'll just search for my storage account. You will have to find the storage account where you uploaded your backpack file. You need to go into the container, and then you're gonna select the backpack file that you want to restore from. Hit select. You can change the pricing tier here. You can definitely do that. I would recommend you look into which one is the right one, you know, so you're immediately restoring to the correct one. For now, I'll just continue with the default. You have to specify a unique database name on the server, so it doesn't have to be globally unique, but on this logical server, it needs to be unique. Let me just do, you know, Data Exposed, right? And then what I need to do is I need to provide it the password for my logical server admin. So this is the password that you specified when you create the logical server. We need this to just restore the database to the logical server. It's not related to anything that might be inside of the backpack, like users or whatever. That's not included here. This is just the admin that has the permissions to restore the database onto the server. Click OK, and in a couple minutes, you'll see the status rolling here. In a couple minutes, you'll have your database restored onto your SQL server in Azure. And that's how simple it is. So I hope this was useful. Please like and subscribe to the channel. Leave us a comment of what you would like to see next, and I hope to see you next time. Thanks.